First, I want you to know directly from me that I never touched anyone inappropriately or made inappropriate sexual advances.
This Sunday, the bombshell report from the New York State Attorney General alleging a pattern of sexual harassment of young female employees by the governor of the state.
We need to take action here because especially in the top levels of New York State government, this should not be happening. It shouldn't be happening anywhere.
Plus, it's amazing what $10 billion in federal pandemic aid can do to bolster a little state.
When you think of this disaster essentially ending up being this gigantic financial windfall, who would have guessed?
Top economists are here to tell us about the road ahead.
Good Sunday morning, everyone. I'm Stuart Ledbetter, and this is NBC5 In Depth. Well, there was no advance warning this week when the Attorney General of New York issued an advisory to the media that she had an announcement she was ready to make. Turned out she'd release results of her outside investigation that detailed allegations of sexual harassment by Governor Andrew Cuomo. She found the complaints by 11 women credible and damning.
The independent investigation found that Governor Cuomo sexually harassed multiple women, many of whom were young women, by engaging in unwanted groping, kisses, hugging, and by making inappropriate comments.
The next day, a Marist College poll of voters across New York showed how much damage was already done. 59% said Cuomo should resign, including 52% of New York's registered Democrats. Only 32% think he should serve out his term, which ends next year. While the governor vehemently denies these allegations, only 7% of New Yorkers believe he did nothing wrong. And if he refuses to step down, 59% think the legislature should impeach and remove him from office. Impeachment would begin in the New York State Assembly. This morning, a member representing Northern New York tells us what he thinks of an astonishing fall. Assemblyman Billy Jones, thank you very much for joining us here on NBC5 In Depth. Letitia James, the Attorney General, sort of laid it all on the line this week. 11 women, 9 of whom were current or former state employees, even a New York State trooper on the governor's detail coming forward to allege pretty serious misconduct by the governor. You needed very little time to make up your mind.
Yes, the report was very disturbing. I have read through it. I'm actually going through it again. And, you know, first and foremost, women in the workplace, in any workplace, should not have to put up with the behavior that the governor endured them to. And they, you know, we need to take action here because especially in the top levels of New York State government, this should not be happening. It shouldn't be happening anywhere, but let alone the top levels in our New York State government. We need to take action to restore confidence in our state employees and our New York State residents as a whole.
Well, this is a 165-page report. It's pretty dense. We've posted the whole thing on the MyNBC5.com website, by the way. What stands out as the most damning allegation to you?
I think we can talk about the individual, the women that were involved in this. The trooper one certainly does stand out, but I think it's the recurring over and over and over the pattern that these ladies had to endure, or that the governor kept it up. It was a pattern. It just wasn't one in particular incident. It was a continuous pattern that these women had to endure inappropriate behavior from the governor. And it's just not right.
On the same day the Attorney General's report was released, the governor issued a pre-recorded video statement in which he said that his attorney had rebutted each and every one of the allegations, that he had posted all of this online. Let me play you now some of the governor's statement.
Please take the time to read the facts and decide for yourself. First, I want you to know directly from me that I never touched anyone inappropriately or made inappropriate sexual advances. I am 63 years old. I have lived my entire adult life in public view. That is just not who I am. And that's not who I have ever been.
What'd you think when you heard that?
I thought his response was just, I don't know. I didn't have the words for it when I was seeing it. I thought it was rather inappropriate at the time. But I will say this, Stuart. I will say for months, and this has been going on for months, back in February, back in March, back in April, back in May, what did the governor keep telling us? Please give time. Please give us the time for this report to come out. I will entrust the attorney general in getting the facts out. When the facts come out in this report, it will prove that I did nothing wrong. I did nothing wrong. So what changed? What changed in that is my question. A little over a month ago, we started to hear, hey, you know, well, maybe this report isn't great. Maybe it's political. We heard that from the governor's people. So the governor for several months, and these are his words, said, wait for the report to come out. Wait for this report to come out. Wait for this report to come out. And now that it's out, it's not, you know, it's not factually correct. I tend to disagree with that. I have read the report. I see a systematic pattern of, a toxic work environment. I see a pattern that the governor subjected these women to that was totally inappropriate in any workplace, let alone the top levels in New York State government.
So the suggestion that, you know, it could be a generational thing or it could be misunderstanding, you don't buy it.
The attorney general of New York State came out and point blank said the governor of New York State broke federal and state sexual harassment laws. Now, if you are the governor of New York State and you don't know that you're crossing the line, that you're breaking sexual harassment laws, then, you know, that's a story for another day, but you probably don't deserve to be the governor if you don't know what that is.
He's also, of course, an attorney and a former attorney general of the state.
I will give him this. He's a pretty intelligent person. I would think you know the line between sexual harassment and not, but that's, you know.
Impeachment would start in the assembly of which you are a member. Democrats are in control. Read the tea leaves. Is this a foregone conclusion that if he does not resign, he will be impeached by the assembly?
It's certainly looking that way. I would say yes. We met in conference this week. And you saw the speaker, Carl Hastie's statement came out pretty strong, saying what the majority conference feels about this and that we want to move forward. People should realize that this is one investigation that we're getting the report on. The Judiciary Committee in the Assembly is doing another investigation and has been doing another investigation for the past couple of months. And when we get all that information together, we move forward. But as the speaker said yesterday, the members have spoken. They said we want to get this done expeditiously. We want to move this process along, and we will. I would only say that if the governor resigned, it would save us a lot of this, and it would save New Yorkers from going through this. It would save everyone from having to endure this in the next couple of weeks.
But you doubt that'll happen?
I think he should. From his response yesterday, it doesn't look like that, Stuart, but we'll have to see what the next couple of days, week or so brings us.
Senate would convict and remove, do you think?
Well, you can go on social media, you can go on Twitter, you can go on certain outlets to see the statements from various state legislators, senators, assembly members alike. Let's face it, it's not looking good for the governor. I would think he could read the tea leaves and read the writing on the wall. This is not going well. And I have to reiterate, If the governor resigned, it would be a lot better for New York State as a whole.
Which would mean that the lieutenant governor becomes governor, acting governor, Kathy Hochul. She's got a pretty low statewide profile, former member of Congress from the Buffalo area. She's 62. I guess her low profile could change in a hurry.
Yeah, I've interacted with Lieutenant Governor Hochul before. She has been to the North Country several times. I would have confidence in her, stepping in and running the state operations. I don't have any worries there. But she would also, as soon as the assembly, different from a federal impeachment, she would step in as governor as soon as the assembly voted to go to the impeachment trial for the Senate. So as soon as we would take a majority vote, she would step in. He would, by constitution, have to step back. She would step in as acting governor.
Well, it's been a long time since we've seen an impeachment of a sitting governor of New York, and what a week. But Assemblyman Billy Jones, the first Democrat representing the North Country in the Assembly in a very long time. Thanks very much for being with us here on NBC5 In Depth.
Thank you, Stuart.
Well, as we said, top Democrats and Republicans were almost united in Washington and in Albany in condemning the governor's conduct. And so were a lot of everyday folks.
What was your reaction to hearing that news?
Sad. I thought he had done a very good job as governor. I'm terribly sorry to say it, but I'm swaying towards him having to either be impeached or to resign.
Very disturbing, extremely disturbing. I worked for New York State. I'm retired, and he has told all of us it wouldn't be tolerated, and he's doing the same thing.
My reaction is I think he should not be in office anymore. Anybody that sexually harasses a woman, I think, is a low life. Sorry, but that's the way I feel.
North Country Republican Congresswoman Elise Stefanik, a longtime Cuomo antagonist, told us, "No one is above the law and justice must be served. Governor Cuomo must resign," and she added, "be arrested immediately." President Biden also urging Cuomo to step down. As we go to tape, the governor insists the allegations are inaccurate, and assembly investigators have given his lawyers until next Friday to submit evidence in his defense. Ahead, the clues in the latest economic data that might tell us how Vermonters will fare, how the state is rebounding from the COVID-19 crisis. In a moment,